It's the final day in East Oxfordshire, and our last host, Peter Marsh, is feeling confident he can win with a more refined evening.
Tonight is about sophisticated food and leaving the best till last.
But his guests are more concerned with his attitude than his food.
I think Peter isn't afraid to alienate people, which I think is okay when you're a guest. I don't know how that plays when you're a host.
I know this is going to sound a bit nasty, but he's almost a bit, like, sly.
I think that Jane and Peter do clash heads a little bit. I think they're both strong and opinionated. I think there might be some more trouble this evening.
However, Peter's left no stone unturned in his effort to win.
I probably am Jane's biggest competition, whether my food is better than Jane's. I really hope it is. I really hope the presentation and the quality of the ingredients really makes it sing.
The proof is in the pudding, or puddings, there's three of them. Espresso mousse, creme brulee, and a deconstructed cheesecake.
I thought this was a three-course meal, not a five. That's all right. I would say just Peter, pick one. I feel like he's trying to please everybody.
If he can pull it off, fair play, but if they're rubbish, I'll tell him they're rubbish.
He starts by making a lemon jelly, squeezing a whopping 8 lemons. He then adds caster sugar, gelatin, and vanilla extract before heating through.
I love cheesecake. It's one of my favourite desserts.
Next, it's onto his cheese layer, blending cream and cream cheese. And after blitzing, it's done. Go on, have a quick lick of the spatula. I said a quick lick, fella. Mm. Oh, good gracious me. He'll build the rest of the cheesecake later and serve with espresso mousse and creme brulee. Next, it's onto the main, slow-roasted rib of beef.
I am sure that Peter knows how to cook a big block of meat.
I think beef is quite risky, because he's got three guests who all would probably like their meat differently.
That's not the way Peter sees it.
Almost absolutely nothing can go wrong with this unless the oven blows up.
After seasoning the beef, he pours over red wine and onions.
This is a winning main course because it's local food, killed locally, served locally.
It goes in the oven to slow roast, so it's on to his starter. Pecorino salad with goat's cheese, roasted peach, and a balsamic dressing.
It is just salad.
Fruit doesn't belong in a salad unless it's a fruit salad.
These are little flat peaches, which I'm going to cut in half and grill just before we serve the salad. I've done everything I can. Nothing can go wrong there.
Oh, cocky. So just time for a quick change before welcoming the first guest. And it's the woman to beat, straight off the beat, Jane.
Hello.
Hello, come on in.
How are you?
Very well, you?
Very well. Thank you very much.
Should come through.
Can't wait. Oh, well done. I think I'm going to like this. Thank you ever so much.
Next, it's quirky student Adam.
How you doing?
Good, come on in.
Thank you. I like your blazer.
Oh, thanks.
Last in, it's Chirpy Charlotte.
Oh, hello.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Coming up, home truths.
You are quite a sort of pompous human being.
I'm actually quite offended now to sit there in someone else's home and rip into them is appalling.
Raucous rows.
I put so much effort into this to make it special for you, not for those two.
He made all of us feel so uncomfortable.
And someone wins the grand.
In fourth place...
It's the final night in East Oxfordshire and the turn of super opinionated salesman Peter Marsh, who's hoping to win the grand with an evening of sophistication. In the kitchen, he's putting the finishing touches to his starter.
I'm really happy with the way the starters look. I really hope my guests enjoy it.
It looks pretty fancy. Et voila! Pecorino salad with goat's cheese and roasted peaches. How's that refined starter going down?
I like cheddar cheese. I like Dairyly Dunkers. I'm not so fond of grown-up cheese, I would call it. But I just don't think I appreciate fancy food. I'm quite a basic palate.
No, it's fine.
It's not really, is it?
It was just a little bit insulting to have someone roll up their nose like a spoilt 9-year-old and say they don't like something and they wouldn't eat it.
I don't appreciate strong cheese.
Salad wasn't my thing. I appreciate the fanciness and I can appreciate the craftsmanship that went into it, but I think he overestimated the development of the palates at the table.
Despite the fancy food falling flat, Peter's not throwing in the towel.
The party isn't over till the fat girl sings. And until we get a good tune out of Jane, party's not over.
Steady on, fella.
So I've got two courses to go, and I can honestly say, hand on heart, these two courses are far better than anything else that I've seen this week.
Clearly, Peter's up for the fight, but he'll need to produce a knockout main. Slow roasted beef with mash and veg.
I'm hoping yours is cooked perfectly, Jane.
So the main course was tasty. It looked really, really nice on my plate. It had some real punch to it, had some real flavour to it.
You do have to chop the fat away from the meat, because that's the fat that gets the meat cooked. But the meat should be almost butter soft underneath it.
I think the beef let him down, I feel. It was very fatty, very chewy, maybe a bit overcooked.
I don't think it was a winning main. I think it looked a lot better than it tasted.
I think the main course was an exceptionally high standard. That's the kind of food you would get in a halfway reasonable restaurant.
Food aside, Jane wants to discuss first impressions.
So when I first met you,
yeah.
I actually thought you were a little bit away with the fairies.
And now?
I just literally think you're such an absolute pickle.
Oh,
you're so sweet. Yay. You're so sweet.
My opinion of you hasn't changed since the first moment I met you.
Okay.
And that was that you were warm, honest, caring. What about your opinions of me? Have they changed?
So you, as Peter, have portrayed yourself as a person that you want us to see. Does that make sense?
A little bit.
The thing is, Peter, you're a very confident human being. Very confident human being. You like the finer things in life, don't you? You do, Peter, you do.
We've got, like, this little pepper thing on the table. I've got a grinder.
My life is as generically ordinary as everybody else's. I just happen to have more nice clothes than most people.
Okay, the way that you've presented yourself, you have led us to believe that you are quite a sort of pompous human being. Sorry.
I don't think I am in any way pompous. I'm actually quite offended now. Jane, would you prefer it if someone said to you, well, you behave like a fat troll and you didn't make much... How would it feel to you?
This is getting a bit personal.
No, I'm being serious here. How would you feel if you were sat at a dinner table and somebody started attacking you?
I think it was just the fact that she was speaking in a critical tone at all that just set the fuse on the tinderbox.
It's about our perception. So it's you can't...
Then your perception is wrong. I think that to sit there in someone else's home and rip into them is appalling.
I just wanted Peter to realise that sometimes he portrays himself as a human being that can be a little bit arrogant, a little bit pompous, a little bit full of himself, and maybe, you know, he needs to, like, tone it down a little bit because not everybody likes that. I'm just saying there was no malice in it, that it wasn't meant for you to feel deflated and sad and miserable. That's not my intent.
Well, that's how it came across.
Okay, well, you shouldn't feel like that. You shouldn't.
I should feel like
you
that
shouldn't.
Because that's how I feel.
You shouldn't, sweetheart. You shouldn't. I've not... I'll
clear some plates, because I've had enough.
I think Peter totally overreacted. I think in that case you can disagree with what someone is saying about you, but you have to listen to them, and especially when you're the host.
He took it all very, very personally. He made all of us feel so uncomfortable. And then his reply just got really personal, and there was just no need for it.
She has all the breeding of a cheap pair of shoes. She goes to someone's house and she carries on.
But the show must go on. You've still got your selection of desserts to serve. Time to put on a brave face.
Wow.
Oh, lovely. Thank you.
The lemon was really, really tart. It was a fight to get through it. But just the pallor that had come over the whole night took away any of the sweetness in front of us.
Dessert was annoyingly nice. That was probably the best part of his whole meal. Your food has been sublime.
I'm sure Peter won't let that go to his head.
I am a better cook than you. I put so much effort into this to make it special for you, not for those two. I knew the other two were here for the experience,
but not you. You were here to win, and I wanted to show you I was worthy of your competition.
Apparently, I'm only here for the experience. It was a fun little piece of shrapnel that I got to take in the face as there was crossfire going on.
It was all about Jane, 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 Jane. And in a way, he really insulted me and Adam.
What you did was came out and attacked me. Okay. And you attacked me because you have no other way of dealing with people.
This has nothing to do with the food that you have put in front of us this evening. What I am saying to you is, I am telling you what my opinion is of you. But you might not like it.
I don't need to hear it in my own home by a complete stranger.
Right. Fine, but I'm telling you what I think of you.
But you're good at telling people what you think of them, Jane. You're not good at hearing the truth.
Sweet cheeks, neither are you. You might not like it, but I'm telling you what I think. Let's leave it there, shall we? The end.
And the scores, dare I ask?
The food was good. It was good. So on that basis, I'm going to score him a 7.
I didn't really enjoy any of the food. He made the evening very uncomfortable and he was quite insulting. So this evening I'm going to score Peter a 4.
Oh!
It just wasn't my kind of spread tonight. And honestly, as I'm walking away, the only flavor left in my mouth is bitterness. And that's why I'm giving a 3.
Ouch! As the host, it's up to Peter to read out the results. This could be interesting.
So let's see who's won. In fourth place is me.
Ah. Why are you shaking your head at me?
You won, Jane.
Oh, my God.
Enjoy the money. I hope it makes you very happy. Dear Lord, what a sad little life, Jane. You ruined my night completely so you could have the money, but I hope now you spend it on getting some lessons in grace and decorum, because you have all the grace of a reversing dump truck without any tyres on.
I don't get it.
Well, you wouldn't, let's be honest. There's nobody in there, love. So, Jane, take your money and get off my property.
Doggy bag, anyone?
So,
well done, Jane.
Thanks.
Just for the record, Charles and Adam came joint second.
It's a travesty that I didn't win. An utter travesty. The best food, the best presentation, the best table, and that I get graded under Adam. Under Adam, who produced a plate of vomit. Under Charlotte, who served up rancid, chewy pork and an undercooked chocolate brownie. So I lose and she wins. I hope she enjoys her money.
Poisonous Pete has kicked us out of his house because he's a very sore loser.
I hope you're not aiming that through his window.
He wasn't impressed that he came fourth, and I don't think he's impressed that he got beat by me, because I haven't got anything going on up here, apparently.
I feel really, really, really great. I mean, this is absolutely brilliant. I'm buzzing, absolutely buzzing right now.
The way that she took that abuse tonight, like, she deserves a billion points.
Despite Peter's little hissy tantrum that he had at the end of the night, good luck to him and all the best. I hope, you know, he's happy. Oh.